Why float in a hotel pool when you can float in your room? Being a private astronaut sounds like a dream, but it's 100% real. As of 2013, 7 private space tourists have slipped the bonds of Earth to go out into space, at least for a short while. We are in the middle of a space tourism revolution, and you can actually start planning your trip today. Maybe you want to take advantage of a package from Space Adventures, where you go on a 12-day trip into Earth orbit. You'll be traveling at 17,000 miles per hour, which is fast enough for you to see the entire surface of the Earth rotate underneath you in 90 minutes. So what's the downside? Well, it costs about $50 million. But hey, maybe that's not right for you. Maybe you would prefer a suborbital flight. Now this would be cheaper and shorter, but it would also mean that you would go high enough so you could see the actual curvature of Earth, you would experience weightlessness, and you'd be about 60 miles over the surface of the planet. So Virgin Galactic estimates that the first 1,000 passengers of its service will spend about $250,000 for this privilege. But a company called XCOR estimates that a shorter flight would cost only about $95,000. One company called Bigelow Aerospace wants to be the leader in space lodgings. They have these space stations they call expandable habitats. Just imagine an orbital rental cabin made out of inflatable fabric. But as long as we're going into space, might as well go whole hog, right? I mean, more than 500 people have been up in space, but only 12 human beings have ever been to the moon, as far as you know. That totally happened. That was not Photoshop. Anyway, an organization called the Golden Spike Company estimates that they could take a person from Earth to the moon for the measly sum of $750 million per person. If we could create an efficient non-rocket launch system like a space elevator or a launch loop concept driven by electromagnets, that could radically reduce the price, but each of those methods have their own drawbacks. Another way to drop prices might be to have the space tourists do science when they go up into orbit on behalf of a professional or non-profit organization. Just imagine, you could reduce costs, you go into space, and you do science. Everybody wins! This is a chance to be part of a human movement that's a new era in our history. And we might be able to answer some important questions that professional scientific journeys have yet to address. Things like, what sort of party games are best in zero gravity? Or what's it like to jam out with your garage band when you're in space? Or even, what baby is going to have the honor of being the first human conceived outside of Earth? All right, guys, I have a question for you. Let's say that you're going out into space, but you can only bring 5 pounds of stuff with you. What would you pack? Let us know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure you like and subscribe to our channel and share it with everybody you've ever met in your life ever. Also, check these videos out.